those who are following Mystery Babylon. All those that are following, who in any shape, form, or fashion, Mystery Babylon. Mystery Babylon is already here in the United States. We are Babylon. We're Mystery Babylon. We followed Baal, the, like I was talking about last weekend, the Masons, everybody that's up there high. They're part of these secret societies. This is, and they secretly worship Baal, these statues of this woman. It's all coming down to what we're seeing here. And the church as a whole need to understand that we got to choose a side. We got to choose to be burned with fire and brimstone, or we got to choose to make it into heaven and be persecuted by this system, this one world government, this one world system. Mystery Babylon is mystery religion. It's a mystery political. It's a one world government. And the popes have always been the Pope has always been, the Vatican has always been political, and they've always had power. So I want to be careful what I say here, but I do want to make you understand today that this is not something that, this is not something that we can just say, no, that's just a coincidence. No, it's not just a coincidence. This is really happening. And so we as the body of Christ need to be on our guard and be aware that even here in the United States, we are a part of these 10 kings. We are a part of the one world government. It's already here. The UN, United Nations is, you know, in New York and Washington, D.C. They're a part of this whole system here. It's already formed. It's already there. We're just waking up to it. It's been, like I said, all over the nation. There's statues of this woman that sits on many waters. As a matter of fact, they moved it from one place. I think it was in Rome, and they moved it all the way to New York City. The Statue of Liberty was given to us many, many, many hundreds of years ago. It's been around for years, but she's not physically what we're worshiping today. What really is being worshipped is this false god Baal, which she represents, but she's just a statue. But in men's hearts and minds, they have went away from God. They went away from God's word. They went away from what is the truth of the Bible. Okay. And so we as children of God need to understand that we're in the last days. We're not coming in the last days. It's coming. It's here. And we as children of God need to prepare ourselves. Even as I was talking about the war of Gog and Magog, all of that is coming to fruition. It's in the Bible. Prophecy is being fulfilled every single day. There is nothing that's going to keep God's people from not serving. There's nothing going to keep me from serving God. I'll tell you that now. But as far as the mark of the beast is coming, that's coming. And that's already forming. Where are they making the microchips to put in the people's hands and foreheads? In the United States. Everything is being made here. So why come we think that Mr. Babylon isn't the United States? It is. We're mentioned in the Bible, but then we're not mentioned because it's a mystery. We're Mystery Babylon, people. United States is Mystery Babylon. We're the ones that have the ships. We're the ones that have the ship sitting on the port, today, to bring it in good and delicacies and stuff like that into the land. And the people are going to cry to see us destroyed. It's coming. In Revelations 18, it talks about the merchants, verse 11, of the earth shall weep and mourn over. They're going to weep and mourn over us, for no man buys her merchandise anymore. That's verse 11. The merchandise of gold, silver, precious stones, pearls, fine linen. It's all wrapped up in the United States. Silk, scarlet, all thy wood and manner of vessels. The United States is one of the most richest countries in the world. We're the ones. There is no other nation like us. No other nation in the Bible. We are Mystery Babylon. We are going to have to make up our minds, though. We're going to have to get out of the system somehow. God's people, this is your wake-up call. This is your warning. Mystery Babylon is America. It's us. We're not that I'm a part of it, because I got baptized out of this stuff. I'm baptized in Jesus' name. I'm not baptized under the Trinity, okay? The Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, only in name only. Father, Son, those titles. That's the Catholic way. I got baptized in Jesus' name years ago. So I've been out of the system for a while spiritually, but we're still in Mystery Babylon. We're still in the United States. We're still in the richest country in the world. And those 10 kings that we were talking about all over the world that have combined themselves, and they're the ones making the decisions, we're still in that situation. We're still in that. We're still in the world. And we're going to have to find a way. Because we, you know, like they say, in a lot of ways, we may become martyrs. And if we have to, so be it. But the biggest part right now is to recognize where we're at. And so I thought to bring this to our attention, because the United States has been looked at as not being in the Bible. We're in the Bible. We're what God is talking about. We kill our unborn babies. We're the ones doing all the wickedness. Okay? It's the United States. And we're going to have to come an account of this. We're going to have to give an account to God of this. Other nations are going to sit and look on us, because we're going to be the ones destroyed. We need to get right, God's people. Get right with Him. It's the time is winding up, and before it's too late. Let's not be a part of this system. Let's not be a part of Babylon. Let's not be a part of Baal. Let's not get in these secret societies. Let's leave and get back to the Bible. Get back to the Word of God. Without doing that, we're going to be in trouble. We're really going to be in trouble. Well, that's all the time that I have today. I want to thank you for tuning in to Bible Vision Ministries. Again, I had a lot of good information. And you can, like I said, watch some parts ones and parts two. This will be probably part two of the video. Portion of it. But like I said before, I want to thank you for tuning in. I hope you learned something today. There's a lot to be learned in the scripture, in the Word of God. And there's much more coming. Again, we love you. God bless you. And keep walking by faith. Praise God. God bless you. Bye-bye.